All right, so which Java development kit version do you need to install and use as a developer? And also, do you have to pay to use it? Let's talk about that in today's video. All right, so welcome back. Thanks for watching. And let's go through this in order. So we're gonna start back at JDK 8. Now that was the version that Oracle brought out in 2014, and that was their long-term support version. So if you started back around 2014, you saw that JDK 8 was updated for years. And in fact, there's still updates available, but basically that's now changing. JDK 11 is the version now that Oracle are telling us is the long-term support version. So in other words, that's going to be supported until at least 2023 and probably longer than that. But where it gets confusing is that there's this long-term support version, version 11, but they're also releasing a version of the JDK every 6 months. And in fact, I'm recording this in March 2019, JDK 12 has just come out. And what's confusing about this release schedule is every 6 months they're releasing a new version, and the version prior is becoming is basically expiring and no longer being supported with no updates coming through. So this makes it quite confusing at first glance as a developer to try and figure out which version you should be using. Now, the next long-term support version of Java is currently, they're saying it's Java 17 or JDK version 17. And by my calculations, that's not going to be released to September 2021. So basically every new version of Java that's coming out between now and September 2021 is going to be a version that expires in 6 months. So consequently, it's my opinion that most companies won't adopt these interim versions unless there's a specific need for a specific version, a specific piece of functionality in that version. What they'll do is they'll stick to the long-term support version, which is currently version 11, then perhaps in 2021 in September when version 17 of the JDK comes out, they'll then update to that. Now the reason for that, for sticking to JDK 11, is that if you move to JDK 12, because of the lack of support, because there's no more updates, particularly security updates, that's going to be a risk for companies. So if you start using JDK 12, you really are committing, having to commit to update your software every 6 months, basically before the support expires and before there's now no longer any future updates. So from a company's perspective, if they've got a large team of people and a large investment in a particular version of the JDK, they generally don't want to update on such a sort of quick release date, because even though it's 6 monthly, for a large application, that is be considered quite a short period of time to try and keep things updated. Because the whole thing is with the JDK, it's updating on a regular basis, things are changing, and it could be quite hard for a company to adopt that stance. And in fact, that's why Oracle have committed to a long-term support version of the JDK. They recognize that it's a considerable investment for some companies to update their software at all, and that's why they're committing to JDK 11 for the long term. So for that reason, I'm going to recommend that, generally speaking, that you stick to JDK 11 until such time as the next long-term support version, which in this case currently, as of the time of recording this, is JDK 17 comes out. And that's going to stand you in good stead, because that's going to be the version that that a lot of companies will be adopting and using. And obviously, if you are familiar with that version, that'll go well if you're looking for a job to basically to work with them. Now, the other thing to keep in mind here with this anyway is that it's likely that some of these changes that are introduced in JDK 12, 13 and beyond, they'll probably be rolled back into JDK 11 at some point anyway. So in other words, it'll be updated at some point anyway. Because if you look back to JDK 9 and 10, those features in JDK 9 and 10 were rolled into JDK 11 anyway. So the point of all this is that it's probably good, in my opinion, if you're a developer, to actually stick to using JDK 11 for the long term, unless you've got a specific reason, specific feature that hasn't been updated in JDK 11 yet. Now, the other thing is I wanted to introduce, I talked about that at the start of the video, as a developer, which version should you use? Because there's two versions of the JDK. We're not talking version numbers here, I'm talking the actual products. We've got Oracle's official version of the JDK, and there's also an OpenJDK. Now, you can use either of those as a developer, but there are ramifications if you're a company. Now, from a developer's perspective, you can download the Oracle version of the Java Development Kit totally free of charge. There's no licensing constraints if you're using that version to develop and test your applications. So basically no problem using that. But if you go to deploy that application, the company, technically the company who you're deploying the application to, will have to pay to use the JDK. This is the Oracle version. However, if you go to the OpenJDK, that's basically an open source product. Since the JDK 11, Oracle are now releasing that as open source, and it's virtually identical in features to the Oracle version. So in my opinion, there's really no reason for you to have to use the Oracle version unless you're writing software for a company that doesn't like to use open source software or has a support contract. They've already got a support contract with Oracle and they're paying for Java anyway. There's no reason for them not to use the Oracle version. So basically what I'm saying as a developer, stick to the JDK version 11, and you probably can stick to either version, either the Oracle version, because it's a good practice to use that, to install that, because that's what you'll likely see at a large company. But you can just as easily use the OpenJDK version as well. Now, just another final quick note with the OpenJDK, with the other version, the Oracle JDK version, companies will need to pay for that, as I alluded to. And currently, Oracle's pricing model is basically per server, per CPU. So what they're trying to do is sort of for enterprise customers who've got a server with lots of CPUs, they're charging, I think it's around $25 a month per CPU off the top of my head. That's a licensing agreement, but that licensing is all done through Oracle anyway. So to be totally free, I would suggest to stick to the OpenJDK. It's open source and it's practically identical to the Oracle version anyway. All right, so JDK 11 and OpenJDK would be my recommendations. But of course, as a developer, you can also use the the Oracle JDK, quite confusing to keep up with these terms. Because you're a developer, you're free to use that to test and to develop your applications. All right, so I hope that's given you some ideas and what to do. And I look forward to talking to you in another video. All right, so thanks for watching. If you've got questions, leave a comment. If you're ready for the next programming specific video, click on the link up here in the top left-hand corner of your screen. To look at non-coding programming related questions, click on the link down the bottom left-hand corner of your screen. Feel free to subscribe by clicking on the link up here, and I'll see you in another video.